excited for this trip?
I am, yes. This will be an adventure.
We'll give you guys the play-by-play. If you haven't had a kid in the bush before, a kid meaning a four-month-old or five or six, we'll give you our review. This is our first time. I'm quite confident it'll be fine, but I'm expecting challenges along the way. So, keep you posted.
Yeah.
Home sweet home. The mountains. Ladies and gentlemen, we are back. When hiking in the mountains, your decisions equal consequences. Trips like this reveal who you are. You have the gear on your back, you have the brains in your head, and you soon discover the metal you're made of. My name is Matt Lambert, and this is my outdoor YouTube channel. Ladies and gentlemen, it's time. Yeah.
Oh,
all right, so we just arrived here. We're just outside of Nordegg. Today we're going to go up Hoodoo Creek. Julie, how's it been?
Pretty good so far, yeah. We just arrived. I just fed the baby in the car. And Matt, Nelly, and Dion. And
we picked up a couple of strangers along the road.
And Charlie went up somewhere over there.
Charlie climbed a mountain, didn't die. It's been good so far. Everything's slower, but we've been just taking our time, and now we're finally ready to leave the trailhead. It normally what would take 5 minutes, probably with the baby, it'll take 20. We are on the trail, ladies and gentlemen. It took us about 10 minutes. It was pretty good. We had four people, so it was pretty easy to be able to throw in the backpacks and the baby and all that. Maybe a smaller group, that would have been a little more challenging, but that wasn't too bad. I imagine, though, later in the trip when we're tired, processes like that are going to become a little more difficult. But for now, we're kicking strong. All right, so we're about 10 minutes in. We just took our first break. Biggest concern right now is Micah overheating. You know, he's inside most of the time right now, 4 months old, and it's 85, 80 degrees right now. So he seems to be doing good right now. We're gonna go another 20 minutes and see how he's doing. Or maybe he's just enjoying the ride and we're all just being wimpy. So we will keep pushing, folks. Hi. So we're like almost a mile in. What do you think? What do you think? You got any comments? No comments.
You're just along for the ride, huh?
Oh, okay. He's thinking about something to say. What do you got to say? Yeah? Hi. No, nothing. Okay, so zero comments from the baby. All right, how's it going so far?
It's hot.
It's hot. Any comments back there?
So far, so good. Beautiful views.
Hot, but good.
Charlie. Charlie's just been trying to find a new owner all day. All right, Charlie's we're getting like, into the hardcore like terrain. Charlie's like, this is easy. No, we are up in the mountains, folks, and it has just gotten a little more serious. How are you doing, Julie?
I'm out of shape.
These mountains will make a fool of any man or woman, in shape or not in shape. Out here, it's a mental game. Go, Julie! Take your time. All right, I'm gonna follow in behind you, okay? What do you think, Micah? Mommy's a bad donkey. There's mama. Hey Charlie, what do you think of the hike so far? So we just stopped for lunch. We've had about a 30-minute break. Julie just fed the baby. How's it going so far?
Pretty good. Yeah, it's hard. That last stretch was pretty hard.
Yeah, no, that's legit. That last stretch there. Any comments back there?
Good lunch break.
Yeah, well-deserved break.
Yeah, good food. Charlie's happy. He's trying to get as much food as he can. Couple more minutes and we'll hit the trail again, folks. Hey, we arrived to the hoodoos.
Yay!
We're along the river now. The path goes either up or down here, and we opted to go down here, which is probably smart. It looks like the path would have been brutal. The famous hoodoos. Charlie's like, I like the water.
Charlie, don't go up that.
Alright, so now that we just passed the hoodoos, now there is a famous technical stretch. So you walk along the rocks and it's a good little adventure piece. So let's go check it out. How's it going?
Good. This is fun.
Pretty nice amount of adventure and technical, but not outrageous either. It's just very manageable for if you're a beginner hiker. If you're a beginner hiker that's, you know, done the basic stuff and is like, I want a challenge. In the summer, this is a good challenge. It's not easy, but it's the next level up. In the winter, I've done this in the winter. Don't do it if you're a beginner. It's the very level up. All right, let's roll. All right, I don't know if there's a name for this boulder, but it's a well-known boulder on this trail. And there's the hoodoos back there. Abraham Lake way back there. This is a little bit of a march. We're really exposed, extremely hot, but after you get over this boulder, there's some shade. So I'm gonna go down there and give the baby a little bit of a break. Hi, Micah. We just found a nice real, well, that big boulder I was just talking to you guys about. We're sitting underneath it and we're getting some cover and cooling off, letting baby cool off. What do you think? What do you think, Micah? Yeah, he's happy. Charlie's happy. How's it going, guys?
We're happy.
Charlie's cooling off. So we're taking another break. Micah's eating right now. We're getting pretty close, but what we're finding right now with the baby 4 months old, it's 80 degrees out here. I think it's like roughly 29. I don't know what Celsius. But yep, we're taking breaks in the shade where there's a breeze. And so far, Micah seems to be the one taking this the best. And then all of us are just like so it's been good. Hey Charlie, where's the basset? Did our basset escape?
No, he's laying down behind your backpack.
Oh. Hi Charlie.
He's ready, we'll see you for a nap. You've had enough, Charlie?
What do you think, Charlie? He's like, this is a nice campsite. Pretty flat. Not too bad.
I can sleep here.
Mike is all good. He just ate.
Uh-huh.
And I think we can hopefully do our last-ish push. So, let's roll. Well, we're very close to the cave. The cave's just over there. We're not going to camp in it. We're going to just camp below. And the sun has just went behind the mountains and it's just cooling off. Great. So we made it to our destination. There's the cave there. And we have over here a little bit of a waterfall. Beautiful mountains. So we are going to take off the packs, do a little recon, and hopefully there'll be some spots big enough for tents. So let's do a little looking. All right, so it's been a very long haul, but we got huge tent set up, like an 8-man tent, and then another tent set up there. Nice fire. She's a little dry today. We'll make sure, always keep someone watching that like a hawk. And we're just about to make supper. It's gonna be a nice view to wake up to tomorrow morning. Hey, cutie.
Hi.
How's it been?
It was fun, but probably the hardest thing I've done in a very, well, since Micah's birth.
Yeah. If you are a wilderness instructor, even just real basic, you've taken 10 people in the woods before, it kind of feels like that. It's fun, but it's also a job, and you're constantly working, and you're always looking out for people, meaning Micah mainly.
This person, this and, little person.
We had to take a break every 20 minutes, every 15 minutes, for sometimes up to half an hour. So what could have been maybe 2.5 hour trip took four and a half maybe. Yeah, roughly.
Something like that. So, yeah, I don't know exactly.
So yeah, if you're an outdoor enthusiast, yes, you can do the hardcore, and I'd say we're outdoor enthusiast. If you're anything below that, then just take your baby off with
camper.
The camper to a normal campground type of deal, or with your tent. But hiking in deep to the mountains, you don't need to be pro, but you definitely need to be very capable of taking care of yourself. Your group needs to be capable of taking care of themselves, and if you're very capable of taking care of yourself, then you need to be still capable for your baby. So if you're not proficient at in the woods for yourself, then you're not going to be able to take care of a baby out here. So I know we'll do it again. It's challenging, but I'm that outdoor enthusiast that I love how hard it is, and I do this to clear my mind and to get a restart. I like doing this every month or two, and it's giving us a good workout. Cooking supper. Charlie's dead, meaning he's super tired. Hey, Charlie. And our friends are having a swim. We're gonna eat supper, and then Julie and I will have a swim. And we'll have hopefully an okay-ish sleep and wake up to a beautiful waterfall and check out the cave tomorrow, which is right there. 10:30 at night. It's raining, pouring. Thunderstorm is moving in. We're on the side of the mountain. Can't do anything but enjoy the storm and wait it out. Unfortunately, our tent will not close. So I am currently getting rained on right now.
And Charlie's trying to escape.
Oh yeah, and yeah, Charlie's trying to escape and try to eat all our survival gear. And Mike is talking to himself. And yeah, Mike is the only one happy. And we are on such crooked ground that we will not sleep tonight. All we can do is rest and enjoy the misery. I just hope that the wind doesn't get so bad, because this tent is too tall for really bad winds. If it gets too bad, we will be forced to move to the cave as our shelter. Stay tuned, folks, this could get interesting.
Good morning, Charlie. Mike is awake, you're awake. Nellie and Dion are just waking up and just about to make breakfast. Little stormy this morning, so we got a cloud over there. But it's not too bad right now. Mosquitoes were bad once the fire got started. Got really good, really quick. No more mosquitoes. Lots of thunder and lightning last night. River definitely grew a bit. Probably change how we have to cross the rivers today. All right, so we came up the falls a little ways. And Charlie followed us. And I'll show you where he fell. Because it's safe here, not safe here. The dog didn't know that. He went here, here, and slid down the waterfall. But he looks a little sore, but he don't look like he broke anything. So, what do you think of the waterfall?
It's beautiful. Really cool.
It'd be cool to plan a trip to go further. You just need the right crew to go on the on the further journey. All right, so we're doing super basic scrambling, a couple inches from the ground, and then even on the ground. But although we're low to the ground, it's still very consequential. Because if you slip, fall into this, you will go down what Charlie just went down. Which is that. Charlie was there, came down there or here. Charlie's so mad, he's like, hey, why'd you make me do that?
It's okay, it's okay. He wanted to go back and rescue you guys, but we wouldn't let him.
Oh, he's chewing us out for doing that.
He's like, that was so dangerous, I just fell down a waterfall.
You stepped into the waterfall.
But we got such a prize.
Yeah, I didn't find any injuries, but he was pretty shook up.
In the end, that was our mistake. We realized that we should have had Charlie on a leash. He did not understand the difference between where the LG was and wasn't, and we learned a quick learning lesson that time. Got lucky with that one. Besides that, it was an awesome trip. What do you think, Julie?
Yeah, I really enjoyed it. I'd do it again. Micah handled it very well. And
storm was awesome.
The storm was scary.
In the end, stay in your comfort zone. When you have the baby, you do not want to take any risk. Stay within what you're comfortable. And we have a more in-depth video, our review on taking a baby in the woods. So if you would like to see that, we have the details on the pros and cons of what we thought on this trip. So if you enjoyed it, please check it out and have a good day.